An Academy. Let's crack it.
I would like to primarily talk about how healthcare can dramatically transform the global economy, which has a major relevance to India. For your information, Cuba trains 6 times more doctors than what is required. And that is what India should do. When we plan to train doctors for Indian, for our country, we should not look at what is our requirement. We should look at what is a global requirement. It is an existential threat for India not to look at the global requirement and train the adequate number of manpower. And it makes perfect sense, because if we train just 5 million doctors, nurses and technicians, we can earn $100 billion of revenue by remittances every year. Now, in what way that $100 billion will impact? It will have a massive impact. The impact will be 1,000 times more than software company earning that kind of money and sending it back to India. I'll give a comparison. One of the most successful automobile industry, which has a revenue of more than 70,000 crore rupees, they hardly hire 16,000 full-time employees. Top line is nearly 65,000-70,000 crores. My company, we have hospitals in some of the cities across the country. We have a revenue of, I guess it's about 3,000 crore rupees. And nearly 20,000 people are employed by us. Just look at the comparison. 3,000 crore rupees revenue, 20,000 people who are hired. 70,000 crore rupees, 65,000-70,000 crore rupees revenue, and you only had 15,000 employees. So essentially, it's a fascinating industry in terms of job creation. We have converted our medical education system as an elitist affair. That's the reason why we do not have that many doctors. That's the reason why we do not have that many specialist doctors. Because of this, entire health system of the country suffers. But something has changed on the 6th of August. On the 6th of August, our central government, Ministry of Health, along with National Board of Examination and NITI Aayog, decided to liberate the medical education. I am almost certain that this will transform the way healthcare is delivered across the country. In US, a nurse anesthetist can anesthetize a patient for a heart operation independently without the presence of a doctor anesthetist. But in India, a nurse who worked in the ICU for 20 years is legally not allowed to prescribe even a painkiller tablet. Unless we change that, nursing profession will never become glamorous. Nursing profession will never become lucrative, because they cannot do anything more because of the regulatory restrictions. We have stifled their progress. So talented, passionate young girls do not want to become doctors. But the way our government has taken the decision to liberate higher medical education, I am 100% certain nursing profession will also be liberated. Most of the developing countries' health strategy is revolving around malaria, TB and HIV. Malaria, TB and HIV, interestingly, kills 3 million people, about 3 million people per year across the world. But lack of access to safe surgery kills 17 million people. Now, if you are the decision-making authority to make the strategy of the country, what you will do? You will concentrate on surgery. Now, I'm not talking about a heart operation or a brain operation. I'm talking about three common procedures called bellwether procedures. That is surgery, emergency cesarean section, laparotomy for a burst appendix, and surgery for a compound fracture. That is when the bone gets exposed after a fracture. If you can do this, about 80% of the surgical needs of the world, you have taken care. You will be shocked that India requires 25 million life-saving operations every year. 65 million life-saving operations every year. And do you know how many surgeries are done in India? Only 26 million. Then what happens to the remaining 40 million people who could have been saved by these simple operations? They gradually die over a period of time. And why they die? We simply didn't train that many people with the skill to anesthetize, skill to diagnose, and skill to operate. Massive campuses, 20-acre campuses, big buildings with so many hostels, college, the classroom facilities. They're like five-star facilities. They have air-conditioned, centrally air-conditioned auditorium, which can seat about 600,000 people. Now, that kind of a medical college which we build in India will cost 500 to 600 crore rupees. That is why medical education has become an expensive affair. Now, do you really need it? You don't need it. I have shown you the photograph. This is the photograph of a medical college in Caribbean region, close to US, Caribbean region. And this medical college, there are 35 of them, they train doctors for United States of America. You know, US has a very high standard. All these doctors are trained in this type of medical schools. But the photograph I shown is not the photograph of the medical college. It's a photograph of a supermarket in which in one area there is a medical college. And they have no campus, they have no restrictions about the air conditioned auditorium. And you will be interested to know that you can buy that medical college for $2 million. And in India it costs huge, millions and millions of dollars to build those medical colleges. It has to change. About 15 or 16 years ago, in the state of Karnataka, there was drought. And farmers lost their capacity to buy healthcare. Because, you know, our government spends only 1.1% of GDP on healthcare. People have to fend for themselves. They have to buy the healthcare. So my friends in Karnataka, rural Karnataka, they all, when we discuss, they're running hospitals, they said, patients are not able to pay for the healthcare. Then we convinced our state government to launch a health insurance. And the health insurance premium, we said it should be 5 rupees per person per month. Our calculation is that if every farmer pays 5 rupees per person per month, if he requires operation, we should be able to pay from that money. Because fortunately, if you collect money from 100 people, only one person will need surgery. So we thought it will be viable. So we launched the scheme. And people laughed at me when I said we can run a health insurance with 5 rupees premium and I can do even the heart operation. People laughed. But the government believed us. And the state government launched the scheme under the cooperative society. First year we had 1.7 million farmers paying 5 rupees per month. Subsequently the number went up to nearly 2.5 to 3 million farmers. At the end of I think around 14 years, 1.2 million farmers had varieties of surgeries. 1,31,000 farmers had a heart operation. just by paying 5 rupees per month. So poor people in isolation are weak, but together they are very strong. So when you want to create a business model, make your business model revolving around the poor people. This is the photograph of a nurse who works in our hospital in Cayman Island. She came from a very ordinary family from Tamil Nadu, worked as a nurse in our hospital. When we started our hospital in Cayman Island, she was one of our brightest nurses. She joined our hospital. And at the end of 3 years of working, she took her family on a holiday to Niagara Falls. How many professions in India will give an opportunity for you to take your parents on a holiday to Niagara Falls? This is the beauty of jobs in healthcare industry. Thank you so much for this opportunity. Good luck and God bless.